Delta Goodrum is one of Australia's biggest selling recording artists, and her latest album has just gone gold here in New Zealand.
She's an award-winning actress and has sold more than 3.5 million albums worldwide. A very warm good morning welcome to you, Delta.
Good morning.
Thanks so much for coming on the show.
Oh, thanks so much for having me.
I was lucky enough to be at Dancing with the Stars just in the studio next door last night.
Yeah, I feel very familiar with this studio now.
In Avalon, here in Lower Hutt. What struck me, I think, first of all, how tall and stunning you were.
Thank you.
I've never seen you in person. But just, you know, you're 23 and that poise you had singing to probably nearly a million people last night. Is that something you had to learn, or were you born with it? Because I don't know many other 23-year-olds who could sing like that without being nervous.
You know what? I think that's just from experience. I mean, I've been with a record company since I was 15 years old now. So I think it's just, I mean, I'm not always, I mean, when I first started, I would be so nervous. Mm. And every single interview, anything, I'd be like, you know, and I remember my very, very first, I think a local community radio station when I was like 12 or something. I remember it was a song I'd written called Lost for Words, and the gentleman said something and I just went, and I've literally gone quiet on air, and I was just like, oh, I'm a bit lost for words right now. Because you learn that it's something you learn. You don't get into music and writing songs and performing to do interviews or everything else. That's something you have to learn. And I think growing up very close to my parents, and I always had such wonderful support from them and guidance and support. I think really that's down to my parents just and my family being a close unit growing up. And I think that's all it is. I enjoy relating to all ages, so I feel comfortable talking to, you know, any age group.
Anyone. Has music always been a part of your life, though? I mean, you started recording when you were like 12. Has it always been there?
Yeah, I think, and my mum would always say that I was singing before I could speak. You know, I was just always singing. And we have footage, like when I did my tour, and we put some footage on the big screen in the arenas, and it was like me singing when I was about 7, singing, I feel the earth move, and it's got, you know, I love singing, and I'm about like this big. It was just something I was born to do. I love it.
And what about the piano, though? When did you start that?
That one was when I was about 7. I played since classical since I was about 7 years old, and then I started composing piano pieces before I wrote songs. So.
But then music,
none of my family music, mind you. Although my dad says that he is singing on all the backing vocals on all the songs.
Oh,
like, that's us, me singing on the backing vocals. I'm going, no, you're not.
Wasn't right on your fame. Now,
no, not at all.
You actually, though, you made your name in acting, though, in Neighbours. So
everyone says that here.
But is that
we watch it.
But is that not what happens?
No, well, in a sense, but I was with my record company and management with music way before I had joined Neighbours. And Neighbours was something that came to us saying we wanted to have a singer on the show. And because I'd been in a TV show when I was about 7 years old called Hey Dad, I don't know if you
know. Oh, yeah.
And a couple of other country practice, a couple of things, that they'd said, you know, there was this article in the paper that said, Hey Dad, now Delta's joined to be a pop star or something. And the Neighbours producers saw that and said, do you want to be on Neighbours? And we said, well, you know what? Yeah, that would be wonderful. And I left school and went straight into Erin's Bahai.
Because, well, you made that film as well, Hating Alison Ashley, which is great. When are you going to get back into acting now? Is it hard with your singing career as well?
You know what? I really do enjoy it so much. Mm. But I at the moment, I've just made this record. It's my third album. And there is so many places in the world that I want to go and sing the songs in. And once I do that, and I think that when there's another time, a next phase of my life, maybe then it'll be then. But
which do you prefer more, live performance or recording the album?
Live performance.
Live.
Yeah, yeah.
Connecting with the
audience. That's the thing. It's the physical feeling you get when you're on stage, and you can see songs that you remember back in your head, just sitting in your house playing piano, writing, and then seeing all these different families and people singing the songs back to you.
Yeah.
And that's your physical feeling. You don't know when you're actually selling an album how it's going. You just are they enjoying it? I know they bought it, but are they enjoying it?
Now, this third album, I read that you wanted this to be, I guess, a more accessible album. Your other two albums, of course, you've been through so much, you know, personally, and they were quite introspective. How did you change the way you wrote this or approached this album?
Well, I was a lot more collaborative than I was on my first two. I tended to go in there saying, I didn't want it to be so intense, obviously, because I came from such an intense time going through cancer, that one side I needed to heal from that myself, and I needed to be able to have, it was like my uni year off that I had, you know, I needed to have my own sort of year off myself and be a kid, and then sort of go, okay, I want this album to be lighter in the sense of I don't want to feel like I have baggage with me of going through those initial cuts you get in life that you have to stitch up first. And I think once I'd sort of stitched that up a bit, I sort of said, all right, I can do a song that songs like Believe Again, which is the video you guys received this morning. It's like, you know, believing again and in this life about letting go and moving forward.
Because you were diagnosed with Hodgkin's when you were 18.
Yeah.
That must have been like such a shock. You know, you're recording, you're acting, and then suddenly you have this illness to deal with. And it's in the media as well.
It was like such a public battle for you, wasn't it?
It was. But you know what? Like so many people go through it, and I was really conscious to not ever make people understand. I knew it wasn't just me going through it. I just understood that maybe that the more people would realize that it does happen to people my age group too, because sometimes you don't associate it with people my age or 18 year olds. And it was so extreme because I had the number one albums at exactly the same week I had got diagnosed. So Planes, Trains and Automobiles into the oncology unit. So it was quite an intense, but I learned a lot.
But you're through it now, though.
I had a lot of support. I mean, I'm so thankful. Not everyone always has that support and goes through it. I had a lot of people supporting me, so I was very appreciative. People who had been supportive of my music were sending these beautiful letters, and it was quite overwhelming.
I want to know about Brian.
Look at her ring.
I know, I have to say. It's huge.
Oh, I didn't notice it, Steve.
You're a woman.
Thank you. You're
engaged to Brian McFadden now from Westlife. How did that happen?
I don't know.
How did you meet?
He asked her.
We met during the duet, but we just became friends, and over time we became absolute best friends in the world. And then it led from there, and I think that, and ever since the day we kissed, we've just, you know, been best friends, and then we felt it was a great time and to get engaged, and he asked me, and it's wonderful. So I'm very lucky.
Is it hard, though, because you're both famous in England particularly?
Makes it easier.
And, you know, if two of you are famous, the media even worse. Does that get on your nerves a bit, the whole
media?
You know,
it depends what type of person you are. It's all about chemistry. It's still the human being, and I think it's about, you know, having how you respond, how I respond to being in the public and how he does. But we both have this wonderful way of balancing, going, okay, but, you know, it's just Brian. We don't look at each other like we're strange people. It's not strange.
Because he's coming out here.
He's releasing his record at the moment. Yes.
And this concert sold out in 3 hours in Wellington particularly. Yeah. When are you going to be touring here?
At the end of the year. I'm booking it all in at the moment. I'm thinking of all ideas constantly. I'm constantly trying to think of ways to do the songs and the shows. And I haven't got to tour here yet.
Because we asked people for questions, and that was
the big
one.
Should we get just quickly to a couple of these questions? Hello, I loved you on Dancing with the Stars last night.
Thank you.
I'm assuming your health is good now. Do you keep in contact with any of your co-stars and neighbours? I enjoy seeing photos of Brian and you in magazines, because you are a gorgeous couple. And do you have any animals? Goodbye, Alison.
All right, well, I'll go back to you. Was the neighbours the first question? I do. Actually, one of my best girlfriends in the world was in part of the crew, Lats, and there was a lot of... Yeah, I still will speak to people from neighbours, so, because it was such a brilliant time.
Well, so much fun. We have a little bit of a surprise for you. Ta-da! Oh. Yes, it is a gold album for you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Do you have any idea where you'll hang out? How many do you have?
I'll find somewhere. There's a couple.
It's nice.
I take great pride and I'm very appreciative. That's very cool.
Oh, well, look, Delta, it's wonderful to have you on the show. Congratulations.
I'll take this home now. Bye. See you later.
Will you come back again? Will you come back on again when you're touring the country? Because it'll have to see you again.
I will. I'll come and visit. You're so lovely. Thank you.
And you'll sing?
Yes, I'll sing.
Lovely.
I'm always singing.
Yeah. Brilliant. Such a pleasure.
Thank you. Such a pleasure as well.
And now for the moment you've all been waiting for, the New Zealand premiere of Delta's new video, Believe Again.